off to work.
Okay, so Brittany, you got a crazy, crazy, chaotic few weeks ahead of you. You're finishing an album, or you're shooting a video, you're rehearsing and getting prepared for this surprise performance for your fans. What does that feel like?
I'm just really excited right now. I have so much going on, and I can't really explain it. Just butterflies, I guess. Hello.
Cool, so we're going to the record plant.
Just because I haven't been out for like a year, the first couple of shows are just gonna have the jitterbugs. Just. Right. I'm excited to hear the new song.
I know, me too.
I can't wait.
Me finally wrapping it up.
Hallelujah.
We're here.
Oh, cool. I can't wait to sing Will.
Yeah.
I've heard that when you go in the studio, you're straight to business.
Down this way.
You get into that mic booth, you may go 3 hours straight.
That's the way I've always been since I've been recording since I was like 16 years old. I'm there to work, I'm very professional.
Do you have any other rituals? Like some people like to bring candles in the studio or?
Yeah, I love vanilla candles. And yes, vanilla candles. And I love my tea. Mm-hmm. My assistant always has me hot tea. Little things like that just to make me feel at ease and comfortable. Just girl things like that.
Oh, girly things?
Girly things like that. Hello.
Hey, what's up, me?
How are you?
Good to see you.
I love Will. I'm a huge fan of his. I love his work. What have you been up to?
Oh, check it out. Show you around. I'm building a car.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. A car. He's all over the place. His brain works in like twisted ways, but he's brilliant.
So that's it right there?
Oh, that looks like something in a movie.
Who's to say that we're only supposed to be creative making songs?
Right. He has a type of energy that's, you know, he walks into a room, he doesn't really say that much, but when he does talk, he's like really, he blows you away.
If this whole, you know, producer entertainer thing doesn't work out, you know, just go work for Intel full time. Okay. At this point, I would rather work for Intel. I get to hang out with people that are responsible for the chips and computers. We talk about making hardware and new devices and stuff. Wait, I know that sounded geeky.
No, I get it. When I went to go hear the song with Will, I was nervous. I hadn't heard the finished version.
I did some tweaking to the Big Fat Bass.
Oh, really? Cool.
Yeah, yeah. The bass is even bigger than.
Okay. I'd love to hear it.
Wanna play it?
Please.
Loud or medium? Or
not too loud, but loud. I was blown away. I was really excited.
Is that one of your favorite songs on the album?
Yeah, definitely. I'm glad to have him on the album. Oh, hot! I love it. Thank you.
Thanks, B.
All right.
How do you actually choose what goes on your album?
I really like to choose songs that empower people and that make them feel good about themselves, first and foremost.
It's great. The song sounds amazing. No?
Thank you. I have a team of people that I work with, Max Martin and Dr. Luke, that I've worked with for a while, that are amazing producers. They bring me a load of songs, but I usually am very quick with the way I work and the type of songs that I like. And if I like it, then I record it.
Femme Fatale, right? What made you decide to call the album that?
It spoke to me because it's seductive, it's mysterious, and it's the main thing is just it's very strong, a very strong woman.
Do you ever feel the pressure to outdo yourself?
I'm at the point where I genuinely want to enjoy myself.
When did you first realize that you were a creative person?
When I was younger, and I was always busy, 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 and I was always singing and always dancing all the time, and my mother would have friends coming over, and they would just be like, Lynn, does she ever shut up? What's wrong with your child? And my mom would just be like, she thought that was normal, because I was just like, really kind of like, just really creative and just really just, you know, like that. And just when my mom realized that I was a very creative person.
This wasn't my idea, but we've all been wet before. All right, guys, here we come. Let's clear path, please.
Here we go. Let's roll playback, roll camera.
After you would do a scene, you'll stop it down and look at the playback. Explain that process. Why do you do that?
Just to make sure it's right and make sure the costume looks right and then the dancers are together and we all look in unison.
When you look at yourself, what are you looking for?
It's an energy and it looks fresh. It just has a certain vibe with it and it makes sense.
At this point of the game, it seems like you're an expert, you know what I mean, when it comes to shooting videos. And do you ever feel the pressure to, like, outdo yourself?
Not really. I feel like I've done so many videos that I'm at the point where I genuinely want to enjoy myself. And I have such a good team of people with me to do them, so we just have fun.
The cameras, could you run to the bathroom real quick? Is it that tight?
It's gonna be the $1,000 thing.
It'll be more.
Can we wrap this? We're gonna go for 10 minutes and done?
That's it, yeah.
Okay. Sorry, you have 10 minutes and you're done. Yep. I don't wanna go in there, it's too f***ing hot.
When people see videos, if they never worked on a video set, they think it probably just happens just like that, but it's all day process.
The set was a little much. It was just like grimy and it was gross and it felt like there was like poop everywhere when there really wasn't. It was just sweat and it was just disgusting sometimes and like, so it was a little much, yeah.
Tough it out?
Tough it out, yeah.
Okay. Thirsty?
I'm fine. Yeah.
Hungry?
Yes, ma'am.
Sleepy?
No.
Grumpy?
No, my feet are aching.
You do a lot of dancing in your heels.
Yes.
Does that hurt your feet?
It hurts. Mm-hmm. It hurts, but it looks good.
At one point, you ended up putting on some Uggs, the Ugg boots.
It wasn't a full length shot, so a girl's about comfort when it's not showing.
Mm-hmm. All that vigorous hard work, you know, at the end of the day, how much fun was it?
It was fun. It was a lot of fun. I'd never worked with Ray K before. I was really happy with the work that we did.
You're from Louisiana, you're not a master chef.
I try to cook, but I'm not that good.
Not working. What is it that Britney Spears does with her day?
I'm usually pretty busy when I'm not working still. It's nice to have a peaceful moment.
Just to sit down.
Just sit down.
It's nice just to relax.
Embrace the moment before the chaos. But I have two children. So I usually get them up in the morning at 6 o'clock in the morning. I send them to school and I'm usually at the gym. I help cook dinner sometimes. I'm not that much of a cook, but I help.
You're from Louisiana. You're not a master chef.
I try to cook, but I'm not that good.
Yeah. You have a special dish?
No. 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 I try a little bit of everything, but I don't have a special dish.
I'm going to give you a hot water cornbread recipe.
Okay.
Okay.
I love those.
I kick myself in this.
Do mine have that many studs on it?
Uh-huh.
They do?
Uh-huh. Yours are black.
I love them.
You and your assistant had a few minutes away from all the chaos.
It was nice just to have a moment to ourselves and just sit and talk about shoes for a second.
Mm-hmm. So when we ever get off, maybe we'll go see a movie. I don't really know what's playing.
We haven't been to the movie in a while.
Yeah. I like to stay home and watch movies.
Yeah. I'm all good.
Well, me too.
How do you balance your motherhood with your professional life?
A lot of the stuff that I do work, I do early in the morning. And so my boys are at school, I'm working.
So today we have a rehearsal, just a long rehearsal really, with the props.
So it's a full day.
I'm feeling pretty good about everything.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Go off to dance.
Thank you.
Five, six, and stop.
We are at rehearsals. We're 3 days away from the first promo performance.
Okay, here we go. Stand by.
A little bit of pressure today, but we're feeling good about it.
And we're on track.
The goal is to get Brittany feeling comfortable with these props because half of this show is built around set pieces. By the end of the day, we want to feel secure in the fact that she knows what she's doing on these set pieces and that no one's going to get injured on stage because safety is key.
Great work. Catch your breath, and then we'll go from the top of grip.
When you finally saw all the props that were on stage on that first rehearsal day, mm-hmm. Describe what that was like.
I'm a perfectionist, so I was just taking it slow.
Perfect.
Cool. Yeah. And stand by. And track.
One thing I noticed about Brittany from day one is the choreography is always important.
I'm more of a big picture person as far as getting with a choreographer, making sure as a whole the show is a good show. It's not about, oh, is this hard enough or does this look good enough? As a whole, does the show speak for itself?
You've always had a great relationship with your dancers.
My dancers are great. We have a great time. They're funny, they're hysterical, and we always have a good time. And we work hard. I've been blessed to have the right team of people to work with.
Just finished rehearsal. I feel really good about it. I have 3 more days to go, so bye.
When you first came out after that video montage, you had to have butterflies.
I was really nervous when the screen first opened.
First came out, you had to have butterflies.
I was really nervous when the screen first opened. Just the energy from the people and everybody being there.
What did that feel like, having not performed for over a year?
It was very exciting. The fans were amazing, and it was really good energy, especially when they're screaming like that. They just hype you up, and they make you feel larger than life, and you're like, yeah, you know? And when you get off the stage, it's just like you just want to go somewhere, you know? And you don't want to watch TV or anything. You're just like, you can't explain it.
Yeah, so. I was excited.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, I almost jumped on stage. performing on stage has to be different from being in a studio or shooting a video.
Oh, they're two totally different things.
How so?
Well, when you're in the studio, you're just like really focused on, and you're, you know, you're really in your head and you're in your ears and like, you know, on the notes and stuff like that. And when you're, you know, performing, you're more of like, you know, a tiger. Like, you know, it's just more, and you're more in your body.
It doesn't just happen overnight. You gotta rehearse and
oh, yeah,
you
definitely.
Gotta practice.
And I still have a lot of rehearsing to do too for tour, so.
Oh, you still got a lot to go?
Yeah, I have a ways to go.
You've been in the business for, you know, 16 years now, so you've been performing over half your life. Reflecting back, does it get any easier, or are you as excited as you once were when you first started?
I'm more excited. I think it gets better as you get older, mm-hmm. Definitely.
Okay, and you're about to be 30 this year?
Yes.
You know, did you think you would still be doing this at this stage in your life? You're still young. I could give you advice on how to be 30, you know. But did you think you'd be doing this at this point?
I think I hoped I would be, because I genuinely love what I do. This is what I love to do. So I think I hoped I would be.
I know Madonna turned 50 and she was still performing, you know. Can you see yourself down the line?
I hope so, yeah.
Doing that then?
Yeah. Maybe just doing nothing. I don't know. But maybe.
Yeah.
I hope so.